Hey guys, Janik here from Cinecom.net and welcome back to another Copycat Friday. And like every year, or the last 2 years, we are going to show you how to get the same look as three Oscar nominees. The films we are showing you today are The Irishman, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, and The Joker. Three super good films with all a very recognizable look. Now, because I'm not the best color grader, I know my basics, but I want to give you the best result, and that is why we are bringing in a guest today. The lucky guest is... Jill?
Woohoo! Screen time, finally! Move away, Janik.
It says not Jill! He's colorblind, apparently. The lucky guest is Jordi.
Hello!
Anyways, my bad jokes aside, today Jordi will explain how to grade your shots in Premiere Pro, while I will do the preparations for the shot and some extra knowledge about the movie. Now let's start with our first nominee, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, a film by my favorite director Quentin Tarantino. And talking about favorites, what's your favorite movie? Let us know in the comments below. To achieve a certain film look, like for instance the orangey look from Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, you of course have to color correct and grade your shot. But that's not the only thing you need to do if you want to create a look. Preparations such as lighting, set and camera settings are also very crucial. It's even 50% of the work to create a look. So with that in mind, let's create a scene from Once Upon a Time in Hollywood as good as possible. We don't have any big old grill signs in the neighborhood. That's why we have to do it with this blue car sign. Then for the light setup, like them you can film on a cloudy day or use soft lights. For the camera, you can use a low angle medium shot.
Hey guys, let's fire up Premiere Pro. We're going to use Lumetri, but before we start, I do have to mention that I won't cover color correction, because I don't know what footage that you're working with, so you're going to have to correct your own shot first, creating a normal Rec 709 look. On top of that, I will show you how to apply the grades. I'm also going to export every grade to a LUT as well, which you can download for free from a link in the description down below. Alright, from the level controls, I'm not gonna do that much, because basically this is the part of the correction. There are some deep blacks in the film, so you might wanna decrease the shadows and the blacks a bit, but other than that, I'm gonna leave it as it is. All of our shots are converted to Rec 709. Now, since blue is very prominent in the film, I'm going to decrease the saturation from the creative tab and increase the vibrance. We've seen the difference between these two controls in the 5 color grading tips from last Tuesday. Next up, jump into the curves. Here's where we are really going to define the look of the film. Make a selection for the blue and the hue versus saturation curves and increase the saturation for it. Next, hue versus hue. Again, make a blue selection and change its hue a little bit more towards the teal, cyan. You can see what happens very well in the jeans jacket and billboard. And finally is the hue versus luma. Again, make that blue selection and then pull it down to make the blues deeper. Finally, jump into the color wheels from which we are going to push lots of orange or yellow into the highlights. And also decrease the exposure of those highlights as well to make the sky really dull. Now this will also affect the talent, so that is why I'm going to push back some blue into the midtones. And that's basically it. Of course, a very simplified version.
Hey Jill, do you want to know something?
Tell me.
Well, do you know Storyblocks Video?
Story what?
Storyblocks Video. It's an online library full of 4K stock clips, backgrounds, motion graphics, and After Effects templates. And the best thing about those templates? You can customize them with your own logo. Everybody in Hollywood is using it.
Oh, holy guacamole, shut the front door.
You're so weird.
Let's immediately continue with the next nominee, and this will be The Irishman. This movie spans over a couple decades, and you can see the actor's age throughout the movie. This is not something you can do with makeup only. So they added infrared markers on the actors, which dedicated cameras could capture. This way they didn't need to remove the trackers in post, and with the special developed software, they could add 3D face models to the actors. Netflix really goes all the way. And another thing they did to emphasize the decade difference was the color grading. In the beginning, they recreated a Kodachrome and the Ektachrome picture style from back in the 50s and the 60s. These were very saturated looks, but towards the end of the film, the saturation reduces a lot and contrast is added. They did this to resemble the story progressing and time going by, but also the feeling of regret from the lead actor at the end of his life. Now for our example, we are going to recreate only one of the looks, and that is going to be the Kodachrome look, which you can see in this chicken scene.
So their setup was quite easy. They used some windows in the back, and that gives you that soft backlight. Then as the main light, they used a softbox on top, then gives you the top light with a grid to focus on the actor. Then pump the room full with smoke or haze, you can choose, throw some feathers in the air, and kill a chicken.
Don't worry guys, no chickens were harmed. The first thing I noticed about the grate in this particular scene are the very deep red colors. To recreate that, I'm going to dive into the hue and saturation curves and locate hue versus luma. I'm gonna use the color picker to select the red of the blood on my t-shirt. Then from this curve, you can pull down the slider to decrease the brightness of the red and make it appear deeper, just like we've seen before with the blue. Now because the skin tones lay so close to red, you might see some weird artifacts. And that is why I'm going to push the hue right from the selected red a little bit up. Now seeing the before and after, this looks really good. Next up, jump into the color wheels. I'm going to push a little bit of green or teal into the shadows. Not too much though, because it's a low light scene. Depending on your shots, you can decrease the shadow exposure a little bit as well. Next up, jump into the Hsl Secondary. From here, take the color picker to select the skin tones. Then tweak the selection a bit further with the hue, saturation and lightness controls. When you got your selection, make sure to also blur it enough. Now matching the skin tones was really hard because by default, my skin tones were very different than those of Skinny Razor. His have more of a red tint. So I'm going to push a little bit of red into the mid-tones, but not too much. You can never get it the same and you want to kind of retain the natural skin tones. Now, because my shadows on the skin tones also become too red because of that, I'm going to add a little bit of the opposite cyan into the shadows. So that should be it for the colors. Furthermore, I'm also going to bring down the levels of the midtones to make my shot a little darker and increase the highlights to bring back that contrast. Finally, go into the creative tab and from here add a little bit of faded film to get rid of those deep blacks. And that's basically it. Again, a simplified color grade of the film The Irishman.
The word on the street is that Storyblocks video gives you unlimited downloads. And the cool thing is that there's only a single super cheap price per year. I know, right? An amazing mighty deal. Even the chickens want it. But they ain't getting it. Storyblocks is mine!
Then our last nominee, The Joker. Again, a super good movie. Joaquin Phoenix delivers the best acting of his career. But besides that, the story and cinematography also takes the film to the next level. For the look, they went for a teal and orange look. But not completely. The orange that they used resembles the orange of the streetlights, which are more greenish. For the shadows, they used a bluish color, which refers to the lonely, isolated state of the Joker. Something they also emphasized with their framing. In multiple shots, they box in the Joker while giving him a lot of headroom, making him small in a world that suppresses him. Now towards the end, they start to use more shots in a low angle, giving the Joker more power and self-confidence. His bad side was winning and taking over his life. Also something you can see in the color grading. Towards the end, the colors start to fade. This is exactly the same with his sanity and hope.
For the Joker, we are recreating the iconic bus scene. In this shot, they use the sunlight from the right and a little bit from behind. We're also going to do this, but first you need to mount your camera to your car. Of course, be safe with that, because broken cameras aren't that fun. Then when you mounted the camera, you can look for a road where the sun comes from the right and just make your shot.
Starting off, I'm going to increase the white balance. A lot. The overall shot is pretty warm, so we can do that from this control right here. From the levels, I'm going to decrease the shadows a lot and also decrease the blacks a tiny bit. This way we're creating more contrast. Now to give it that harder look, increase the whites, but also make sure that you're not clipping anything. And like before, a lot will happen within the curves. This time select the yellow from the U versus U and increase that a tiny bit, making the yellow a bit more orange. This will also affect the skin tones, which is no problem. For the U versus Luma, select the yellow again and pull it down to make the yellow colors deeper, just like with any other example that we've done before. Finally, jump into the color wheels where we are going to push teal into the shadows. Not too much though, just a tiny bit. You can also go ahead and decrease the shadows of this control as well, depending on your shot, of course. Next, to the mid-tones, where you want to push some red in. This is to counter the teal or green that we've added in the shadows and make it a contrast with the skin tones. Now this will also affect the highlights, where we would now like to push in a little bit of green. Whenever you're going to change a color within any of the wheels, it will always affect the entire shot, so that is why you always kind of want to counter that with the opposite color in the other wheels. So yeah, here's the result.
Of course, I can get Storyblocks video by clicking the first link in the description below. I don't have to be sad anymore. And you can too!
And we have something else to be happy about, guys. The three LUTs Jordi exported especially for you. You can download them in the description below. And that was it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks video for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Hey guys. So, what was the plan?
You go away, I continue.
Okay, bye guys. Allee, moet je nu weggaan?
Dat was goed.
Dat was de bedoeling.